Roxy and I'd like to welcome to my channel. Today I will show you how to make this beautiful and elegant sweater. You see, this is the sleeve with big bubble, and here is the rest of the sweater. The idea of this sweater started from a picture that I saw on Pinterest. It was a children's sweater, but the picture that I saw is a sweater knitted. But after many attempts, I succeeded and I really like it. For this sweater, we need three very important things: perfect yarn, perfect crochet number that is suitable with yarn that you use, and the perfect buttons. For this project, we need 5 stitch markers. I use yarn for this 4 stitch markers, yarn needle, and scissor. The yarn that I use for this sweater is Alize Cotton Gold Plus. It's a soft yarn, and this yarn has 55% cotton and 45% acrylic, and each skein has, see, the meters and the yards, and I use 10 skeins because at the sleeve we need more yarn. This sleeve you can make at many different sweaters because it's elegant and beautiful. Okay, so crochet that I use is 5 millimeter European size or hash for US size. At this sweater I use 5 types of stitch. No, sorry, 4. Sorry. Single crochet, double crochet, front post double crochet, and back post double crochet. This sweater is work fast because we use a big crochet number and a thicker yarn. It's not hard to make, just you need a little attention at the beginning, and then it's very easy to make. At the sweater, at the first row that is made only with double crochet, here I use another crochet number. I use 4 millimeters, so the crochet number 4 is for the sleeve at the first row and here at this elastic edge. Okay, so please subscribe to my channel if you like my work, and enjoy this video. Leave a comment if you want and share with your friends. So let's begin. So I chain 115 and I divide the stitch this number of stitch as follow. For the back, I make 28 chain, and it is 17 centimeter or 6.69 inch. Just remember, when we chain for the back, always the number of chain must divide by 2, because here in the front we divide by 2. Fourteen chain here. Okay? And for the left and the right, I chain 22, who is 14 centimeter or 5.51 inch. But this is for my model, who has the size S. And of course, with my crochet number, who is 5 millimeter or hash for US size. So this is for my model, who has the size S. So I have 22, 28 in the back, 14 chain in the left. And after you make the number of chain that you need, you make 4 in plus 4 chain, 1, 2, 3, 4 for the corners, and 10 plus 1 chain, because this part must come over the outer like that. Okay, so this 10 chain plus 1, the plus 1 chain is for skip and chain that we use at the first row, so don't count like anything. Okay, so the number of stitch that you need for the back, but must divide by 2. Okay, and then the number of stitch that you need for the left and the right, plus 4 for the corner, and plus 10 plus 1 for this part that came like that. If you make this sweater for a child, this 10 chain, for a child you can make 8 plus 1, okay? So let's begin. And very important, sorry, number, count the number of stitch that you need for the front, for the first part, and then in the next stitch put a stitch marker. Then count the number of stitch for your shoulders, and in the next stitch put a stitch marker. Then count the number of stitch for your back, and in the next stitch put a stitch marker. Then Count the sorry, the number of stitch for the another shoulders, and in the next stitch put a stitch marker. Then you count the number of stitch that you need for the front, and in the next stitch put a stitch marker, and then you make this part that came over the outer. Okay, I put the stitch marker now because it's more easy. I don't want to count how many chain I need. Okay, so add a stitch marker, except this first stitch marker. So 1, 2, 3, 4, here we make the corners. Okay, so let's begin. Skip one and into the next stitch make one single crochet. Into the next, I think it's not see very good. To the next single crochet. All the sweaters is make with single crochet. Okay, so work single crochet until you reach at the second stitch marker, and then I will show you how to make the corner. So I crochet until I reach at the second stitch marker, and here we make 3 single crochet in the same stitch. 1, 2, and 3. Sorry. Okay, we have 1, 2, and 3. Take the stitch marker and put into the second single crochet that you make in the corner. We have 1, 2, and 3 here in the second, because at the next row you know where you must make the corner. Okay, so the stitch marker always we put into the second chain at the corner, second single crochet, sorry. Now we continue to make single crochet in every stitch until we reach at the next corner. Okay, so make single crochet until you reach at the next stitch marker. Here at the next stitch marker make again 3 single crochet in the same stitch, put the stitch marker into the second single crochet that I show you, and then continue. Okay, so single crochet corner with 3 single crochet in the same stitch, single crochet in every stitch, in the next corner 3 single crochet in the same stitch, and the last corner 3 single crochet in the same stitch, and then finish the row, and then I will show you the next row. So I finish the first row. Don't worry if your work look like that, because after you make some rows the sweater looks very nice, okay? So each part of this sweater has 7 rows. So I make one row, and then I will make 1 more 2 rows, and on the row number 4 we need to make the button holes, because we need to sew the button, okay? So each part has 7 rows, and this, and each part is make, first we make 3 rows at the row number 4, we make the button holes, and then we make again 3 more rows, and then we change. When we change, I will show you how to make it, but after we finish the row number 7, we chain here 11 stitch, and we work until here minus 10 stitch, okay? But now we need to make 3 rows, and then we make the button holes. Chain 1, turn your work, and make single crochet in every stitch, okay, until you reach other stitch marker. Other stitch marker, you make 3 single crochet, and then you continue to make single crochet in every stitch. Look, the work is really nice. It's true that the yarn that I have is soft, and it work really nice with this yarn. So I make single crochet until I reach other stitch marker. Okay, so single crochet in every stitch. Other stitch marker, we make 3 single crochet. 1, 2, and 3. Insert your hook into the second single crochet that you make at the corner, and then put the stitch marker here. Okay, so it's not complicated, just a little attention at the beginning, but it's not hard to make. So okay, so make 1, 2, and 3 rows, and then I will show you how to make the button holes, okay? I finish the row number 3, and now I work the row number 4 all the way around until I have here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So other row number 4, work until you have 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay? And then I will show you how to make the buttonholes. Okay? So I crochet until I have here 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And now we make the buttonholes. Always the buttonhole is made at the part that came over the other. Okay? So we chain 3, 1, 2, and 3. Skip 3. Stitch 1, 2, and 3, and to the 4 make 1 single crochet and 1 single crochet into the last stitch. Here is the button that I want to use. You see? It is very nice. And now I need to make one more 3 rows with single crochet in every stitch. Okay, so we make single crochet in every stitch for 3 rows, and in total we have 7 rows for each part. Okay, so make one more 3 rows. Look, the button will be like that. See? So make 3 rows, and in total we have 7, and then I will show you the next step. I finish the row number 7 and the row is finished at the short part. And now I take this stitch marker and I count here where it is the buttonholes. I count 10 single crochet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And I put here. Because when we make the row number 7, we work until here. Here is the last single crochet at the row number 8. Okay? And we remain here 10 single crochet. And now we chain 11. 1, 2, 3. Ten stitch is for 10 single crochet and 1 stitch for skip and chain. And we make single skip 1 stitch here, and we make single crochet in every stitch. We need to have 10 single crochet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And now we continue to make single crochet in every stitch like I show you. Okay? And look, this part came over the outer, and then this part came over the outer. Okay, so make, now you make 3 rows, work normally. At the row number 4, make the button holes that I show you, and then make again 3 rows and change. Work until here, chain 11, and your work look like that over the outer. Okay, and make so many rows you need. Until you obtain the space for the sleeve, but make sure, because it's a sweater, need to be a little larger. Okay, so work so many rows you need, but the sweater must be a little larger. And after you obtain the space for the sleeve, I will show you how to join the corners. Okay, so I obtain the space for the arms and also obtain the length for the back, but I still need to make a little larger, because this sweater needs to cover very good. We need to look like that, not when you put on you like that. Okay, so we need to make a little larger for my model. And you crochet until you reach at the first corner. I take the stitch markers, because from now on I don't need it. And one moment, because I need to reach at the first corner. Okay, reach at the corner. Into the corner make one single crochet. In my case I need to chain 5, but you can chain 3, 5, 7, 9, wherever you need. So in my case, I chain 5. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. And you take the next corner and into the next corner make again one single crochet. And now you continue to work normally, single crochet in every stitch until you reach at the next corner. At the next corner, make exactly like I showed you. Why I make 3, 5, 7? Because when we begin the slave, for example, in my case, I have 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. When we begin the slave, you count 1, 2 and into the third we begin exactly in the middle. If you make 3, you count 1 into the second. Here you begin the slave. If you make 7, you count 1, 2, 3 into the fourth chain, you begin the slave. Okay? So you now make exactly like I show you at the next corner. So one single crochet into the corner, then chain 3, 5, 7, 9, wherever you need. But after you, and then make 2, 3 rows, and then put the sweater on you, and if you cover perfect, you continue to work until you obtain your length. Okay? And then I will show you how to make the collar, and then at the end the sleeve. We make the collar before you make the sleeve, because after you make the collar, we make the edge all the way around. And I will show you after I finish my length the collar. Okay? I finished this part and I obtained the length that I need for my model. And now it's time to make the collar. Why we make the collar right now? Because after you make we finish the collar, we make the edge all the way around. Okay? If your work look like that, don't worry, because after we make the edge here, where we have this long part, we make slip stitch all the way around, and after we make the collar, we make a little shell. And after this part is ready, look, with the button, we sew the button, and look how beautiful it is. See? It's true. It's more buttons, but I like it very, very much. So after you finish your length, don't cut the yarn, because we begin the edge here at the bottom. So don't cut the yarn, because in my case I don't want to begin another skein without finish this. So I work with the wire like that, and I begin the collar with the yarn like that. So one moment, the collar is make exactly the same like this part. So we make a slip knot . Okay, and we begin here into the short part, long and short. We insert the hook into the first one moment. Okay. And we chain 11. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. And we turn the work. Skip one stitch and we make 10 single crochet. One moment. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Now we continue to make single crochet in every stitch until we reach at the corner. At the corner, at the each corner, we need to decrease. So I work until I reach here. Okay? I make single crochet until I reach at the corner. At the corner, insert your hook into the first single crochet and then into the second single crochet and join them and pull tight. Okay? So this is the decrease. And we make in every corner. And also we make for every row. And also we make 7 rows exactly like I show you. 3 rows work normally. At the row number 4 we make the buttonholes, and then 3 rows. In total we have 7. But if you, for example, if you decrease 4 rows and you obtain the collar close to the neckline, the rest of your rows you don't decrease at the corners. But I think in my case I will decrease for every row. Okay, so we decrease in every row. I make this row and then I will show you again how to decrease at the corner. It's not hard, but we need to decrease, like I tell you, to obtain the collar. Okay? I finish the first row, and you make sure you work until you remain here 10 single crochet, because we apply the same pattern like we make at the rest of the sweater for the collar. So after you make the first row, we chain one and we also turn our work, and we also work until we reach here at the corner, at the last two here, 1 and 2, because we always decrease here. And now we, for example, in my case, this is the outer part. When we decrease at the outer part, so each single crochet has 2 loops, 1 and 2, 1 and 2. When we work at the outer part, we decrease like that. We insert our hook into the first loop and then into the next loop, and we make the decrease. It's a little harder, but oh my God. Okay, now we continue to make single crochet in every stitch. You see, this is the decrease, but after we turn and we work at the inner part, we decrease also at these two single crochet, but we don't insert your hook into the front. We insert our hook into the back. Like that and like that. Okay? Because I don't want because here we make the invisible decrease, and when we make at the inner part, I don't want to see the decrease. Okay, so you continue to make exactly like I show you with 7 rows, and then I will show you how to make the edge all the way around. I finish the color. It's exactly the same, and I decrease at every row, and it's very close to the neck. If you don't like this color, you can make any kind of color you want, but it's not ready because when we reach here, we make shells. Okay, so now you take your sweater here where it's finished, and you make like that. See, insert your hook into the in this space and make slip stitch into the next it look like that. So here we make only slip stitch. When you reach here, you make one slip stitch here and you continue to make slip stitch look. I make more. See, it's really nice. Continue, okay, all the way around. I make some. Okay. And one more. Look. You see? Here is without slip stitch, here is with slip stitch. And it look like that. I make slip stitch. Now you continue to make slip stitch like I show you all the way around until you reach here at the first single crochet at the collar, because here we make a little shells. Okay, I make slip stitch all the way around until I reach here at the collar. Look, here is with slip stitch and here is without slip stitch. So here at the first single crochet at the collar we chain one and in the same stitch make one single crochet, then yarn over, skip one stitch, into the next make three triple crochet, one and three, one, two, and three. Skip one stitch, into the next join with one single crochet and it look like that. One more. Skip one stitch, into the next make three triple crochet, one, two, and three. Skip one, into the next, join with single crochet. Once again. Skip one and into the next make three triple crochet, one, two, and three. Skip one and join with one single crochet. So work all the way around until here. When you reach here, you continue to make slip stitch like I show you here. So make slip stitch until you reach at the last stitch here, and when you reach here you also chain one, make one single crochet in the same stitch, then skip one and stitch, and in the next stitch make three triple crochet, exactly like I show you at the neckline. So this shells is made at the neckline, here at the bottom, all the way at the bottom, and after we finish the sleeve, we also make the sleeve. So continue to work like I show you, and then the last step is the sleeves. Okay? So as you can see, I make the edge and I sew the bottom. Look, it's really nice. And the edge at the bottom. See? It's really, really nice. Now, and I make the sleeve. It bubbles. It's really, really nice. At this sweater, I tried different types of sleeves, but none like it. So I decide this sweater needs a special sleeve, and this is the result. Do not worry, because this sleeve is not difficult to make. You need to know how to make double crochet, front post double crochet, and back post double crochet. And is a multiple of 12. So you count the number of stitch that you have, and if this number is multiple of 12, you don't need to increase. But if the number of stitch that you have is not multiple of 12, you need to increase some more times until you have multiple of 12. But only at this row we need to increase. In my case, I need to increase 4 times. So I increase here, 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 and here. Okay? This row don't count at the model at the bubble, because at this row we need to increase, and this first row is only double crochet all the way around, and of course with increase that you need. Each bubble has 4 rows. Okay, so let's begin the sleeve. One moment. And this first row that we make with double crochet and this elastic edge is made with different crochet number. In my case, I crochet all the sleeve, including the sleeve, with crochet number 5. But first row and this elastic edge I make with 4 millimeters. So we begin with the small crochet number, not with the crochet that you make all the sweater. And here in the middle, you make a slip knot and chain two. I always chain two for double crochet, not three. And make in the same stitch the chain two, don't count like one double crochet, but only at this row. Okay, and make double crochet in every stitch. And of course you increase where you need. Okay, so double crochet in every stitch all the way around. Okay, and we will meet at the end of the row and we begin the bubbles, the first row at the bubbles. I finish this row and I obtain the number of stitch who is multiple of 12, and we join with slip stitch into the first double crochet, but only at this row we join into the first stitch and join with slip stitch. Now I change the crochet with the crochet that I work all the sweater, and we chain two. One, two. This chain two is count like one double crochet, and in the same stitch make six double crochet. In total we have seven. So one, two, three, four, five, six, and seven. So one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Into the next two stitch we make two front post double crochet, one front post, and again one front post, back post, sorry, back post double crochet. Now this is the beginning at the first bubble. Now we make seven unfinished double crochet, and it's make like that. One, two, three, four, five, six, and seven. One, two, three, four, five, six, and seven. And we join them and hold tight. Into the next two stitch, we make again two front post, back post, sorry, two back post double crochet. One back post and two back post. And now into the next stitch we need to make 7 double crochet in the same stitch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So this row is work like that. 7 double crochet in the same stitch. Into the next two stitch we make 2 back post double crochet, then we make 7 unfinished double crochet and join them, and then we make again 2 back post double crochet, and I make one more time. So I make 7 double crochet in the same stitch. Into the next two stitch I make 2 back post double crochet. One and two. And again we need to make 7 unfinished double crochet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And we join and we continue like I show you until you reach here, and then I will show you the row number 2. I almost finished the first row and I reach at the last two stitch. The last two stitch we make back post double crochet, sorry. 1 and 2. And we join with slip stitch into the chain 2 at the beginning of the row. And this is the first row. And after you join with slip stitch into the chain 2, we make a slip stitch between these two stitch and chain 2. 1 and 2. And it's count like 1 double crochet. And now we make front post double crochet at this shell. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. The next 2 stitch, we make back post double crochet. 1 back post double crochet, 2 back post double crochet. And now we yarn over and insert the crochet here. Is form a space here, and from the back insert your hook here in the first space at this back post double crochet, and we make a double crochet. If you make like that, this double crochet look like front post double crochet. You see, like that. And now we make again 2 back post double crochet, 1 and 2, and we make again 7 front post double crochet, and I make one more time. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4. Five, 6, and 7. Okay. Into the next 2 stitch, 1, 2, we make back post double crochet. 1 back post, 2 back post double crochet, and yarn over, insert your hook here in this space, and then from the back, and we make 1 double crochet who is look like 1 front post, and again 2 back post double crochet. Continue to work like I show you this second row, and then I will show you the row number 3. I almost finished the row number 2, and I need to make the last 2 stitch, who it is 2 back post double crochet, 1 and 2. Join with slip stitch here into the second chain. One moment, please. I don't know why. Okay. Make a slip stitch between these two double crochet and chain two, one and two. Now we make again 7 front post double crochet. This chain two is count like 1 front post double crochet. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And now we make 2 back post double crochet exactly how it is. One and two, and here we make 1 front post double crochet, and then we make again 2 back post double crochet. See? After you make 7 front post double crochet, you make 2 back post double crochet, 1 front post, 2 back post, and now you repeat 7 front post double crochet, 2 back post double crochet, 1 front post, 2 back post. Okay, I want to tell you this row number 3 and the row number 4 is make the same. So finish this row number 3. After you finish, make the last 2 back post double crochet, join with slip stitch into the second chain, make again with this 7 front post double crochet, and then 2 back post double crochet, 1 front post, 2 back post. So the row number 3 and 4 is make the same, okay? And then we change the order at this shell and we form the bubble, big bubble, okay? And this bubble came like that, one here, one here, one here, one here, okay? I finish the row number 3 and 4 at this bubble from the back, look like that. And now it's time to begin another 4 rows for the second part of bubble. So now we finish this and begin this. So I make the last 2 back post double crochet, and then we join with slip stitch into the chain 2 and we make again 1 slip stitch here between these 2 double crochet and chain 2. This chain 2 counts like 1 double crochet or 1 unfinished double crochet, because now we make 7 with this chain 2, 7 unfinished double crochet. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7, and we join them. You see, the bubble is formed. Now we make 2 back post double crochet that order with this back post double crochet don't change, but they look like that. 2 back post, 2 back post, 2 back post, 2 back post double crochet. And now here where it is the front post double crochet, we make 7 double crochet. 1, 2, 3, 4 5, 6, and 7. So we close a bubble, we form another, and 2 back post double crochet into the next 2 stitch. 1 and 2. And now we repeat, and I will show you one more time. So here we make 7 unfinished double crochet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7, and we join them. Look, the bubble. And now into the next 2 stitch we make 2 back post double crochet. 1 and 2. And here where it is the front post double crochet, we make 7 double crochet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So I close the bubble, I form another. Work like I show you all the way around, and then I will show you how to join here. Okay, I finish the first row for the second set of bubble, and last 2 back post double crochet. And now we don't yarn over like I show you at the row number 2 here. We join with slip stitch, we insert the crochet here in the space, and then here, and we make a slip stitch and chain two, one and two. Okay, so this will be the and it look like one from post double crochet like this, and you continue like I show you at this first set, so row number 2, 3 and 4 is make exactly the same. So, 2 back post, here we make 7 front post double crochet, here we make 2 back post double crochet, then yarn over and we make a double crochet who is look like one front post. So row number 2, 3 and 4 is make exactly the same like I show you at this first group. And after you finish the second row, last back post double crochet, make it, and then we join with slip stitch here into the chain two, and then chain two and continue row number 3 and 4. Okay, I hope you understand how to make this slave, and you make so many rows you need until you reach like here where is this finger, because then we need to make this elastic edge, and I will show you how to make it. And this elastic edge is the last part at this sweater. Okay, so continue after you make more rows, you see how beautiful it is. Okay, so I crochet these bubbles until I reach us here, and now it's time to begin this elastic edge. So join, after you finish, join with slip stitch into the second chain, and now we change the crochet number. I crochet with 5 millimeter and I change with 4 millimeter, like I begin the first row with double crochet. So change the crochet number. So chain two, one and two, and now we close this bubble like I will show you already, and make 7 unfinished front post double crochet. Six and 7. We close the bubble. And now we make two front posts, double crochet, one and two. And here we make front post, double crochet, and then again two back post, one and two back post, double crochet. Okay, once again, this is the first row at this elastic edge. One more time, we make 7 unfinished front post double crochet to close the bubble. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Now we work exactly how it is. 2 back post double crochet, 1 front post, 2 back post double crochet. And this is the first row at this elastic edge. You work until you finish this first row, and then I will show you how to make the row number 2. Okay? I almost finished this row with 2 front post, back post double crochet, sorry. And now we join with slip stitch exactly like I show you when we make the bubble. We insert the hook here into this space and then from the back into the first back post double crochet, and we join with slip stitch and chain 2, 1 and 2, and we continue. 2 back post double crochet, 1 front post, 2 back post. So 1 back post, 2 back post double crochet, 1 front post, 2 back post double crochet, and here we yarn over and insert the hook here into the space and from the back into the first back post double crochet, and okay, one more time, 2 back post double crochet, 1, 2, 1 front post double crochet, 2 back post, 1, 2. When we make this double crochet, it look like 1 front post, you see? And yarn over, we insert the hook into the space and here into the first back post double crochet, and this is the second row at the elastic edge for our sweater. Okay, I finish this row and then I will show you the next row. I finish the second row at this elastic edge. As you can see, it's not too large, but after you make some rows, this elastic edge begin like that, a little tight. Okay, so I finish the row number 2 and we join with slip stitch here into the chain 2 at the beginning of the row. And now we make again one more slip stitch and we insert the hook here from the back and we make a slip stitch. In that way, this first stitch, look, it look like one front post. And from now on, you work exactly how it is. 2 back post, double crochet, 1 front post. Okay, 2 back post, double crochet, 1, 2, 1. Front post. Once again, 2 back post, 1, 2, 1 front post. You see? So work until you obtain your desired length until here, and then your sweater is ready. I hope you like my sweater and please subscribe to my channel for more tutorials and bye bye.